So it's wonderful to be speaking about the Bhagavad Gita on this most auspicious occasion of the Gita Jayanti. So I'll speak on the significance of the term, the two names that Krishna uses last, in the last verse of the Bhagavad Gita, to refer to Arjuna. So the theme I'll speak on is, the Gita provides Partha with Paramartha. The Gita provides Partha with Paramartha. So we see that the last verse which Krishna speaks in the Bhagavad Gita is, he says, Kachideta Shutam Partha Tvayeka Grena Chetasa Kachida Jnana Sammoha Pranashtaste Dhananjaya. So he says, this is 18.72, where he's speaking, O Arjun, Kachid Etaj Shutam Partha. O Arjuna, have you heard attentively? And after having heard attentively, what has happened to you? Kachid Agyan Sammoha. Has your ignorance been dispelled? Pranashtaste Dhananjaya. Dhananjaya is, O Arjun, who are the conqueror of wealth. So here we see that Krishna uses two names to refer to Arjun. One is Partha and other is Dhananjaya. Now Partha refers to Arjun, who is the, what does it mean? Son of Pruta. Yes. Now it's interesting, the first two names that Krishna uses to refer to Arjuna are also Partha. In 1.25, when Krishna first tells Arjun, go into the middle of the two armies. At that time he says, okay. So Arjun, he speaks, at that time 1.25, Krishna tells Arjun that, just see, Bhishma Drona Pramukta Sarvesham Cha Mahikshitam Uvacha Partha Pashyaitan Samavetan Kuruniti. So Uvacha Partha Pashyaitan. So he says, Partha, O Arjun, just see. And then after that, again he says that, that's the first reference. Then second chapter, and this again he first time refers to Arjuna. Kutastva kashmalamidam vishame samupastitam anarajushtam asvargyam akirtikarum Arjuna klaibhyam masmaga mahapartha naitattvayupapadyate shudram rudaya daurbalyam tyaktotishtha parantapa. So he says, O Arjun, have you, where has this weakness come upon you? So they are also using the word partha. So now, Prabhupada explains that Partha refers to Arjun, who is having a great dynasty, great lineage. He is coming from a great mother. And the defining characteristic of Pruta, of Kunti, she is a very great lady, but she is also a great devotee. So what Pruta, a mother would naturally want to give to her children, is that which is the greatest wealth she has. Her greatest wealth is her devotion. So when Krishna refers to Arjuna as Partha, he is also referring to her that you are the daughter of a great, you are the son of a great devotee. So that it behooves you to act in a devotional way. That Partha is not just a relational name, it's also a devotional name. Because that relationship is with a devotee. Now, at this particular point, in the Bhagavad Gita, Krishna and Arjun are about to fight a war. And Arjun says that this wealth is not worth fighting for. In the second chapter, in the sixth verse, he says that, should I fight and win? Should I just give up and lose and go away? I don't know what is good to do. And then in 2.8 he says, even if I win, it's not going to help me. Nahi prapashyami mama panadhyaya chokamuchoshanam indriyanam avapya bhumava saptanam riddham rajyam suranam apicha adhipatyam. Even if I get, what to speak of this earth, but even if I get the heavens, still that is not going to remove my grief. So at one level, Arjun is saying that the is a futility of wealth in removing his grief. So there are different levels of needs that we have. Wealth is obviously needed, but for living in the world, money we need it. But if somebody is grief struck, if somebody has lost a loved one, then money can't console them at that time. So our emotional need is a deeper need. Wealth cannot substitute for that. So Arjun is saying, if I lose Bhishma, if I lose Drona, if I lose these loved ones, what will wealth do for me? And yet, when Arjun is talking about the futility of earning wealth, Krishna at the end of the Bhagavad Gita, the last word that Krishna speaks is Dhananjaya. Oh Arjun, who you are the winner of wealth. So the implication there is that the Bhagavad Gita is itself the knowledge that provides us ultimate wealth. And in the previous line, when Krishna is asking Arjun, have you heard attentively? That means if you have heard, you understood, and then your illusion will be removed. And when the illusion is removed, then we can see things clearly. So I was in America, and one month ago I was in America. So when it becomes cold, often there is snow and there is mist. And when the mist is there, we can't see anything at all. And at that time, if the mist stays for a long time, actually sophisticated and expensive technology is used to try to heat and drive away the mist. Or people, their car lights have to be very, very high level, so that even then they can see a little bit distance only. So at that time, if something can remove the mist, that itself is very valuable. So knowledge removes, the Bhagavata's knowledge removes the mist of misunderstanding within us. And that empowers Arjun to see the right road ahead of him. So Arjun is thinking that this kingdom is one wealth. So he's thinking at a physical level, the kingdom is a wealth. But at a relational level, at an emotional level, my relationships with Bhishma and Drona, it is a greater wealth. So for gaining this physical wealth, I don't want to lose this relational wealth. But Krishna tells Arjun that above this emotional wealth is your spiritual wealth. And spiritual wealth is Arjun's internal relationship with Krishna. And Arjun's service in the world to establish dharma. So Krishna is telling, the whole purpose of the Bhagavad Gita is to raise Arjun's consciousness from the physical and the emotional levels to the spiritual level. And he tells, so from the body to the soul and from the soul to the super soul. That is the journey of the progression or the theme of the Gita. So when Krishna is telling Arjun, have you understood the Gita? That means, and then he says, have you understood the Gita? And O winner of wealth, is your misunderstanding removed? That means removing of misunderstanding is the greatest wealth. Sometimes if a very wealthy person becomes an alcoholic and then they want to give up alcohol, but they're just not able to give up. Sometimes people spend millions of dollars to try to go to some de-addiction program to give up alcohol. So if somehow within them that misconception, those impressions which are there, which make them think that alcohol is enjoyable, when it actually is causing them great suffering, if somehow that misconceptions could be removed, then people who are addicts are ready to pay a lot to just become free from that addiction. So similarly, all of us have various misconceptions. Fundamentally, the misconceptions about what will make us happy. We think various material things will make us happy. So Arjun is caught in the dilemma, relations or possessions. But Krishna is telling, beyond possessions and relations is devotion. So Arjun is thinking, I don't want to value possessions, I will also value my relations. That's good. But among our relationships also, among our relations, our supreme relation is the relationship with Krishna. And Krishna is telling Arjun that by getting this knowledge of the Bhagavad Gita, you can become, have you become free from illusion? Have you enriched yourself with the wisdom of the Bhagavad Gita? And That is the greatest enrichment. And when that inner enrichment is there, outer enrichment will also follow. Because that's what is told at the end of the Bhagavad Gita. Yatra Yogeshwara Krishna, Yatra Partha Dhanurdhara, Tatra Shrir Vijayo Bhutir, Dhruva Nitir Matir Mama. So Bhuti is opulence or wealth. So the outer enrichment will also come. But the Bhagavad Gita's central message is to offer us the inner enrichment. The enrichment of devotion. The enrichment more of the knowledge by which we can make devotion our goal. The enrichment by which we can get the process by which we can develop devotion. So the knowledge and the process to develop devotion, that is the enrichment that the Bhagavad Gita offers us. So if there is a mist, we don't even know whether we are on the road or we are on the footpath or we are on the ditch. So first of all, we need to have a road. We need to see the road. Okay, this road is into the destination. That is the knowledge. And then, if we are to walk alone, it might be difficult. If you have a vehicle, we can go much faster. So bhakti, in Bhagavad Gita, the sadhya and sadhana are told. What is the wealth that Bhagavad Gita is providing? Sadhya is Krishna and sadhan is bhakti. So these two truths, if somebody understands, then they have understood the essence of the Bhagavad Gita. And Krishna enriched Arjun even before the start of the Bhagavad Gita with this truth and with this wealth. And with that wealth, Arjun was able to fight and be victorious. So similarly for all of us, on this auspicious day of Bhagavad Gita, by the mercy of Srila Prabhupada, we also have that knowledge of sadhya and sadhana. There are many different people who have different commentaries in the Bhagavad Gita. And they have all illuminated some aspects of the Bhagavad Gita in their own ways. But often, this central point of the Bhagavad Gita, sadhana and sadhya, they do not give it so clearly. But Srila Prabhupada makes it categorically clear. We can say, some people say, how do you know Prabhupada's Bhagavad Gita is as it is? There are so many Bhagavad Gitas. Yes, there can be so many Bhagavad Gitas. But let us see what is the understanding that Arjun got after the Bhagavad Gita. Is Prabhupada giving us that? Arjun's understanding was, as far as the sadhya is concerned, he says, Param Brahma, Param Dhamma, Pavitram Paramam Bhavan. He says, after Chatushloki Bhagavad Gita 10.8 to 11, he says, Krishna, you are the absolute truth. That means he is accepting Krishna as the sadhya. And then as far as the sadhana is concerned, Arjun doesn't say, I will fight a war. Next words, Arjun's response is, Karishe Vachinam Tava. I will do your will. That means he is actually surrendering. He is surrendering to Krishna. And surrender is what Krishna told, Sarva Dharman Parityajya Mam Ekam Sharanam Braja. So Sharanagati is a limb of bhakti. The Bhagavad Gita itself, from Arjuna's actions, demonstrating that the sadhan is bhakti, the sadhya is Krishna. And there are many technicalities in the Bhagavad Gita. Prabhupada focused on this essentiality. The essentiality is that Krishna is our goal and bhakti is the sadhan. So that is the wealth that we all at one level have already got. But it's a wealth we have to realize. So as you keep practicing bhakti, we'll start realizing more and more the empowerment, the enrichment that the Bhagavad Gita's knowledge offers us. Krishna is there in our hearts. As we practice bhakti more and more, we realize His presence. So on the Gita Jayanti day, we can pray that Krishna's message of love in the Bhagavad Gita enter deeper and deeper into our hearts and thereby enrich us in this life as well as in future eternally. So let's conclude with the prayer. Once again, prapanna parijataya,
prapanna parijataya,
totra vetraika panaye,
totra vetraika panaye,
jnana mudraya krishnaya,
jnana mudraya krishnaya,
gitamrita duhe namaha,
gitamrita duhe namaha.
Shri Gita Jayanti ki, Shri Prabhupada ki, Krishna Bhagavan ki, Gaur Premanande.